participation in the 4th Mathematics National Seminar. Now I am going to give you a short presentation about the resolution of the nonlinear programming intended by an iterative projective interior point method via modulus function for nonlinear programming. I begin with an introduction in which I will talk about the linear and nonlinear programming and the Kalman-Kapper method for solving the linear programming. Then I will extend the Kalman-Kapper algorithm in the nonlinear case. Firstly, I define the problem formulation, the transformed problem, the linearization, the optimal solution, and the step size. Then we study the convergence, the algorithm, the general algorithm of Kalman-Kapper, and we prove the efficiency of our study by numerical tests. And finally, we finish by a conclusion. Introduction. The linear or nonlinear programming is the process to minimize a linear or nonlinear function subject to linear or affine constraints. In 1948, Kalman-Kapper proposed a new polynomial algorithm to solve just the linear programming. And since of its polynomial type and theoretical properties, we think to extend the resolution of linear programming to the nonlinear case. The problem studied is minimize a nonlinear, convex, and differentiable function f, in which the optimal objective value z start is known from the beginning. Now, we know the value of z start, we just need to solve the x start. Subject to constraint, the ax equal b and x positive. The matrix A is full rank matrix. And for sure, there exists strictly interior point x, 0.
The matrix A is not square.
No.
You have system linear.
We will see so.
Okay. Continue.
La matrice A, c'est une matrice
rectangulaire.
The principal idea in the Kalman-Kapper algorithm is to transform the X original space to Y transformed space. Kalman-Kapper have a problem in the space in a polyhedron or simplex. He made a transformation to another space from the first space. Minimize f of x, he transformed with transformation tk to another space. First, we Kalman-Kapper work with in a polyhedron. Now, he transformed the problem in a simplex. The first thing in the algorithm is to obtain a strictly interior point. Then, at any iteration k, we transform the point xk to the center of simplex A. At each iteration, the point xk will be the point A in another problem. Now, from the point A, we must calculate an optimal step size alpha and descent direction tk to get a new point, which is yk. Firstly, we begin by xk. Then, after the transformation, we get the point A, which is the center of simplex. From A, we get another point, which is the point yk. From A to yk, we just need a descent direction and step size. Now, when we get the yk, it must reform from the simplex to the polyhedron. From yk, we have the inverse transformation tk to get the next iteration xk plus 1.
How about the inverse transformation? Also exists?
Yeah. Also. Transformation of Kalman-Kapper is a transformation dimensional. Cette transformation, jusqu'à maintenant, est unique parce que la transformation du Kalman-Kapper réserve les propriétés de le premier problème. The first and the second problem are equivalent. Now, generally to calculate the next iteration xk plus 1 from xk. We were in the same problem and the same space, but now we need another space, the simplex. We can't calculate the next iteration directly. The important concept in this algorithm are the projection transformation, the linearization. As I say, the function which I will minimize is a nonlinear function. But the algorithm of Carnap-Kapp works just with the linear function. Then we need the potential function to calculate the step size and to study the convergence. The Carnap-Kapp projective transformation is defined by here we have the y equal tk of x. But the problem is that x is in Rn, but y is in Rn plus 1. For this, Carnap-Kapp calculate the yi from 1 to n low, and he made that the yn plus 1, the last component, equal to 1, minus the sum of all the components. The inverse transformation of Carnap-Kapp is directly equal to. Now, as I said, we transform the first problem to the second problem. Instead of minimizing the function f of x, we minimize the function h of y. The function h of 1, first we have f of x, now we have f of tk minus 1 of y. That start is the optimal value from the beginning. Here we transform the constraint, the first and the second constraint, and as we say, that y is a point from the simplex. Now, as I say, we must linearize the function h. Generally, to linearize the function, we just need the development of Taylor. But in our case, we have in trouble if we choose just the development of Taylor. The development of Taylor is a minorant of a function. It's a linear approximation, but it is minorant, not majorant. But in our when we must calculate the step size, we use the majorant function technique. So for that, to avoid the problem, we don't work with the tangent, we add a parameter beta. But when we add the parameter beta, we must to ensure that the tangent be sequent of h. Now, when we calculate beta, we define the new problem. The h of y becomes a linear approximation, a linear majorant approximation of h. Here we calculate the optimal solution of the problem 6. We minimize the linear function subject to this constraint. We just firstly replace the y minus a by x. Then we have two Lagrange multipliers lambda and mu, and with simple calculate we get that x start equal and the descent direction dk is defined by. And finally, as we said, that x equal y minus a, so the y is a plus x. And x start is minus alpha r dk. And we replace by the inverse transformation of Carnap-Kapp to get the next iteration xk plus 1. Here, in the yk, the formula of yk is defined by the alpha and dk. So dk is calculated. by sk, but the alpha is must to calculate. And for calculate the step size, we define the search the line search function theta, which defined by the potential function p associated to the first problem, which defined by. And with simple calculation, we have the formula of theta. Here the proof, the, how to calculate the theta.
Here's some references that we use in this work, and thank you for your attention.